Good morning, students. So in earlier class, we seen the design of cylinder, piston and connecting rod. And coming to today's class, so we are going to design so another important machine component in IC engine. So that is a crankshaft. So the main function of crankshaft. So we know that so what is crankshaft? So it is a main shaft in the IC engine. So in order to take in power to the output shaft, so here we call it as also it is called as an output shaft. So the main power is going to take out from the shaft, that is a crankshaft. So the big end of the connecting rod, we are going to connect to the crankshaft, so that whatever the impulsive force that are observed from the piston, so that is directly converting by means of connecting rod to the crankshaft. So here, so it is a main function. So it is convert this rotary motion, reciprocatory motion of connecting rod into rotary motion of. So the materials used for crankshaft is mild steels, that is carbon steels. So which ranging from 30-46 or 40-C8 types of steels with the carbon percentages. So as well as alloy steels that based upon the capacity of engine. So and it is going to manufacture by means of drop forging process. Clear. So here the crankshaft is again the main parts in the crankshaft. We have three parts in the crankshaft. So one is that is a crank. So another one is a web, and the third one is a main shaft. So here, so this crank pin or the crank, so that is the big end of the connecting rod. We are going to connect to this crank pin. So and then the web. So it is used to connect the crank pin as well as the main shaft of connecting rod. So and the main shaft which will rotates inside the main journals of an engine, so that the shaft we call it as a main shaft. So here this crankshaft is going to classified. So that is the crankshaft can be classified into two types. So one is a side crankshaft. And second one is center crankshaft. So side crankshaft, as I stated that, so here it is a crank pin, so or the crank. So this is the portion of web, and here so the main journal is going to be present, and here we have so supports for the main journal, and here we are having support for the crank, so that so here can use it to connect the big end of connecting rod, and this is the portion we call it as web, and this is the main journal. So this is the side crank. The support is going to be observed only at the main shaft. So here this type of crankshaft we can also call it as a overhang crankshaft. So here depending these kind of side crankshafts or overhang crankshafts are observed for the single cylinder engines or the light capacity engines, and coming to the heavier capacity engines, so we can go with the center type of crankshaft. So in that so the crank is going to be support by means of two main journals. So for example, so this is a crank, so this can be supported on both sides of the crank, so in this fashion. So if you observe clearly, in the case of side crankshaft, the main journal is only in one side of the web, that is a crank is supported only on either left or right side of the crank. So but in the case of center crank, we are having the two number of webs, and this is the crank, and it is supported by means of two main journals. Clear. So this is the type of center crankshaft we have. So again, the center crankshaft can be classified based upon the number of cranks we have. That is based upon the number of cylinders. So if it is a single cylinder engine, we are having the only single crank is there. If it is a multi-cylinder engine, we are having the number of webs. Like in this fashion, we are having another crank and another web. So in this fashion, we are having the number of cranks are there in the shaft. So depending upon the number of cylinders, so this crankshaft is going to be defined or classified. That is, we call it as a single throw crankshaft. So which means we are having only a one number of crank is present, or the crank pin is present in the crankshaft, that we call it a single throw. Or if it having so number of that is a more than one, so we are call it as a multi throw crankshaft. Clear. So single throw crankshafts, which are used generally for single cylinder engines, for the multi throw, for the multi cylinder engines, the crankshafts we use called as multi throw crankshafts. So in today's class, let us so in as per our syllabus, we are having the design of crankshaft. So we need to see look into both the side crankshaft and the center crankshaft as well. So the side crankshaft is first of all in this class, let us see so how the side crankshaft is going to design. And if you are aware of how the side crankshaft is going to design and the center crankshaft, which is a very simplified form which comes out from the derived from the single, that is a side crankshaft or overhang crankshaft. So let us go into the design. So how the, what are the forces acting on the crank, and what are the proportions we are going to use for the design of side crankshaft or overhang crankshaft, and how the, what are the different stresses induces in the components like crank and web and the main shaft, and we need to check how overhang crankshaft. So here, so let us see the proportions. So these are the three parts. So here the main that is big end of connecting rod is going to connect in this portion. So this we call it as crank, and this is the portion which joins so the crank to the main journal. So it is the journal which will be supposed to support by means of the bearings at this position. So and that joins so this is the main journal, that so it is the web portion which can joins the crank to the main journal. So if you observe the side view of the web, but that can be in the portion of so with the increase in diameter. So here you can observe so in this shape. So here it is. So this is the width of web at near the crank is taken small a, and the width near the web near the main journal is taken b. So the mean width, so you can take it as that mean here, that is denoted by w. Clear. So this is how the overhang crankshaft is observed. So for that the cap small l and small d is denoted for the length and diameter for crank, and capital L and capital D is for the length and diameter for main journal, and L1 is the length of crank inside the web, and capital L1 is the length of main shaft inside the web, and T is the thickness of web, and W is the mean width of web. So that that are the proportions you need to remember, and I can also note down the distance from the centers from crank to the main journal, that is denoted by R, that is equal to the crank radius. And x is the distance from supporting end. So here the bearings are supported from this end to the acting load acting. We are considering here the load acting at the center of the crank. So that so the distance from the center of the crank to the supporting of the nearest support are taken as the perpendicular distance as x. So clear. So here so in the design of crankshaft, so we need to design three components. So in the design of connecting rod, we can consider the main stresses inducers in the connecting, that is a crankshaft. So here the stresses, that is for obtaining the stresses, we need to observe the stresses in, that is a forces acting on the crankshaft. So here it is a line of stroke. So this is the force that comes out from the combustion process. This is the connecting rod and this is the crank. So here it is an angle is denoted with the theta and it is phi, and the included angle is beta. And these force can be resolved into two components. So one is Fr and Ft. Clear? So for the design of crank shaft, so you need to understand so what are the stresses induced in the main components in the connecting rod, that is like crank, web, as well as the main journal. So first of all, I can go with so the crank or the crank pin. So that is the stresses induces in the crank pin. So here, so whatever the force, whenever the force acting on the connecting rod, that is connecting rod to the crankshaft, that the force F is going to resolve into two components, the radial component and the tangential component here. So here, for obtaining the dimensions of the crank pin, so the effect of the components of tangential and radial component does not affect any design, that is does not produce any effect upon the crank. So that for the design of crank, so we are not considering any component of forces. So simply you can take the maximum force acting on the connecting rod is directly taken as the force acting on the crankshaft. So that so the stress induces on the crank pin is also taken due to the only the force F. So here the forces acting on the, that is a force acting on the crank pin. So we are not considering any component of forces or the radial component or the axial component, tangential component. We consider only the direct force acting on the crankshaft, that means that is a maximum gas load. So here whatever the stresses induces in the crank pin, that is only due to the force F. So we are not considering any component of forces. Clear? So here what are the stresses, various stresses induced in the crank pin? So that is three types of stresses induced here. So one is here the load is acting in this direction, that is directly acting here. That is a total load F is acting at the, assuming that it is acting at the middle of the, at the center of the crank pin. So that so there is a, it is acting perpendicular to the axis of pin, so which will cause us a direct shear stress of the crank pin. So that the initial, that is the first type of stress induces in the crank pin is a direct shear stress. That is direct shear stress. So the shear stress is denoted by tau. So here we can know that, so how to write the shear stress, that is a shear stress, tau can be written as load by area or load by cross sectional area. So here the load acting on the crank pin here, that is we are not considering any component of forces. So the load acting on the crank pin is only a simple load directly from the connecting rod, that is F. So here it is F. Then the cross section area, it is a circular cross section, pi by 4 d square, so 4f by pi d square. So this is the direct shear stress acting on the crank. So and this is, and then second force, that is a second stress induces, so due to the force acting on the crank pin, so there is a chance of a bending of the crank pin. So this may be a chance of bending at, so that we can consider the bending stress at the fixed end of the crank pin. So that is a bending stress. At fixed end of crank pin, that is denoted by sigma b. So we can know to calculate as this bending stress is given by m by z. So but we need to know, so how the maximum bending moment acting on the crank pin is going to calculate. So here it is acting at the center of the pin, so we can take so the load bending moment is given by F into, so here the length of the pin is taken is equal to L. So I can take F into L by 2. And the section modulus Z is calculated by, so it is a circular member, so pi by 32 d cube. So from that the bending stress is given by 6 into FL by pi d cube. So this is the bending stress induced in the crank pin, and this is the shear stress induced in the pin. And the third type of stress can also be induced in the crank pin, that is a crushing stress or bearing stress. So here the crushing stress, so why the crushing stress is calculated, that we already know the connecting, big end of the connecting rod is always in contact with the crank pin, so that so there will always compressive forces acting under the under compressive forces. It is always in contact which produces the bearing stress or the compressive stress, and this is going to calculate by using the relation. So bearing stress or the crushing stress equal to load by projected area. So here the load is F, so there is no component of forces are considered for crank pin. So we can simply take the maximum gas load acting on the connecting rod, the same load is acting on the crankshaft. So here the load is F and the projected area is L into D. So using this load F, so we can use the calculated different stresses induced in the crank pin. That is what first one is the direct shear stress, so that is a tau. So and the second one is bending stress at the fixed end of the crank pin. And the third one is a crushing stress. Clear? And the next one, so that is you need to find out the stresses induced in the web. So let us see. So and the next component, that is a web. So here in design of web, unlike of crank pin, so here so the maximum stresses induces, that is the magnitudes of the loads may vary so based upon the different crank positions. So that the design of crank web is going to consider at a maximum loading conditions, that is the piston at that is a theta. So here we consider the two different maximum loading conditions, that is when crank angle is zero, so as well as included angle between the crank and the connecting rod is 90 degrees. So these are the two crank positions of the maximum loading conditions we consider, that is the crank angle with respect to the line of action is zero, and the included angle between the crank radius and the connecting rod is 90 degrees. So why? Because so here there is a different magnitude. As I stated that the total load is going to divide into two components, like a radial component FR, so that is given by F into cos theta plus phi, and so the tangential component Ft, so Ft equal to F sine theta plus phi. This is the two component of forces that can be derived from the maximum force F. So here due to with different angle of rotation of the crank, we can obtain the max different load magnitudes. So for the design, we don't able to calculate thus many of number of stresses, so that we can consider only the maximum loading conditions. For that we are having the two conditions. One is when the crank angle is zero, so that is theta equal to zero, and the included angle is 90 degrees, that is between the crank and connecting rod is 90 degrees. So these are the two conditions we consider for design, and the stresses induces in the connecting rod, sorry, that is a web. So the stresses induced in the web is going to give in this form. So these are the stresses induced here. The radial load is acting in this direction, that is FR. So instead of F, so here at the middle center of the crank pin, so the radial load is going to act, and the tangential load is going to act in this direction, that is Ft. So here, so we need to consider the stresses induces in the web. So here the initial stress acting, so that is the axial stress or direct stress. Axial stress or direct stress due to radial load. So here I can calculate, this can be denoted by sigma naught. So sigma naught equal to, so you know that direct stress or axial stress, which means it is acting along the axis of the web. So I can take a cross section here, so it may use the cross section as a rectangular one here. So the cross section of the web is so with the mean width of W and the thickness of web is T. So here axial stress is nothing but in tensile or direct stress, that is load by area. So here the load acting, that is so clearly due to radial load. So we can take FR here, and the area is a rectangular cross section W into T. Clear? So this is the direct stress or the axial stress acting on the web. And the second type of stress induces in the web, so that is a bending stress. Bending stress, so that is particularly about that is due to radial load. So I can denote this bending stress with sigma br. So its general equation is m by z here, but the maximum moment acting on the web. So I need to consider up to this distance for the bending moment, so that the maximum bending moment in the web is going to give. So m equal to, so it is due to radial load. So fr into l plus t by 2. So I can take so half the length, so l plus t, so by 2, that gives the total bending moment acting in the web due to radial load or radial component of load. So and the section modulus z is given by, so that is w into t square by 6, that is about the x-axis, so that w width, the t square is the depth, w t square by 6, that gives the section modulus. So by substituting the values in this equation, you can calculate the induced bending stress due to radial load. So and then there is one more type of stress is going to act in the web, so that is again the bending stress. So but it is due to tangential load. So again I can denote with sigma bt. So why? Because so it is due to tangential load, so that I can denote with sigma bt, bending stress due to tangential load. So but here the maximum moment, so in the which direction it is going to bend means so here the tangential load is acting in this direction, so that this crank, the total web is going to bend in this direction, so that it is going to bend in this form. So it is going to bend in this section, so that the bending moment is going to calculate ft into, so that is the distance from load acting to the support, that is taken as a perpendicular distance r. So ft into r, that gives the moment acting at the in the web, so due to tangential force. So and then section modulus z is given by t into w square by 6. So by substituting both the values, you may get the bending stress due to tangential force. But if you observe clearly, so this is that these two stresses are due to the tensile force, that's a radial component of forces, but this bending stress due to tangential force. But here we are calculating so the maximum force when that is a loading condition, that is a two cases we are taken. So if you observe, if you take a case one, if theta equal to 0, so then fr is going to be f, but ft is going to be 0, that is a case one. So and the second case, beta equal to 90 degrees, then fr is going to be 0 and ft is going to be f. So these are the two maximum loading conditions we are considering, that is a maximum crank angle, that is theta equal to 0, and the included angle is 90 degrees, so that this component of stresses is going to equate it to the maximum load acting, that is f. So these are the three stresses induces in the web. So but the resultant stress induces in the web is going to be given as the sum of all the stresses induced in the web, that is sigma naught direct or axial stress due to radial load, and the bending stress due to radial load sigma br plus sigma bt, that is a bending stress due to tangential force, that the sum of all the stresses gives the total or the maximum stress induces in the web. Clear? So and the next, going to the design of main journal, that is main journal. So after finding out the stresses induces in the crank and the web, so we can also need to calculate the stresses induces in the main journal. So likely, so similar to the web, so what, however we are designed the or observed the stresses induces in the web, so at the maximum loading conditions, that is the two cases, so as I stated, that is the theta equal to 0, as well as the included angle between the crank and the crank radius, that is connecting rod, that is beta equal to 90 degrees. So these are the two maximum loading conditions we can also consider for the main journal. So that is when theta equal to 0, fr is going to be f, and ft equal to 0, and if it is taken the second case, beta equal to 90 degrees, so that is fr equal to 0 and ft equal to f. So the same loading conditions we can also consider for the stresses inducers in the main journal. So here, what are the stresses inducers? So that is the first type of stress induces in the main journal, that is a bending stress. So here, due to the radial load, so due to radial load, so the support is present at here, so due to radial load acting on the crank bin, there is a chance of bending of the main journal here. So with the distance of offset distance of x from the load acting to the center of the support. So that is a bending stress. So first one is bending stress, induced bending stress due to radial load. So and it is given by sigma b equal to m by z. So again, that is a generalized equation, but here, so how the bending moment is going to calculate is a important point. So the bending moment acting due to radial load here. So here the load is acting at this center of the crank. So and it is support at the center of the main journals, but the offset distance is x here. So here the load is acting is fr. So that is due to radial load, the bending is acting. So fr into, so the offset distance is x. And you can take fr into x by 6. Sorry, so it is not 6. So fr into x, and the section modulus z is, it is a circular member. So pi by 32. So you can denote with d, capital D is a diameter of main journal. And the second stress induces, so again it is a bending stress. So but the stress is due to tangential force. So here, so the tangential force is acting, so the bending can takes place or occurs in this direction. So again, with the distance of perpendicular distance of r, so it is going to bend, but the generalized equation, so it is m by z here, but the bending moment here, it is denoted or calculated by ft into, so that is the radial distance r. So and the section modulus is same, which is a circular member, pi by 32 d cube. Clear? So but here, if you observe clearly, the radial load as well as the tangential load are acting per right angles to each other. So here it is in the direction of fr and it is the direction of ft, so which are acting perpendicular to, so that the stresses induced, the bending stress induced can also be perpendicular to each other, so that we can also calculate the resultant bending stress. Sigma b is given by sigma br square plus sigma bd square. So from that I can calculate the resultant bending stress induces in the main journal. So and finally, so the third stress you can also observe in the journal, main journal, is a torsional stress. So that is a torsional shear stress due to rotation. So here whenever the tangential force is acting, there is a chance of rotation of the main journal. So that induces the torsional shear stress, it is. So by of because of the tangential force. So here the tangential torsional shear stress, that is a tau s or tau, can denote with, so 16 t by pi d cube. So but here the torsion acting or torsional moment acting on the main journal is going to give by, so it is a tangential force ft into, so and then here the distance is r, so ft into r. So clear? So as the basic thing, that is here the main journal, if you observe clearly, the main journal is going to acting both the normal stress. So here the resultant bending stress, which is a normal stress, and it is a torsional shear stress. Whenever the shaft or the any of the machine component is going to act with both the normal stress as well as the shear stress, we need to calculate the maximum stresses induces, that is a sigma b max. So maximum principal stress we are need to be calculated, that is given by sigma b by 2 plus root of sigma b by 2 whole square, that is a tau s square. And similarly, you can also calculate maximum shear stress induces in the main journal, so that is root of sigma b by 2 whole square plus tau s square. So this is how the stresses are going to be calculated that are induced in the web, crank pin, as well as the main journal. So three components in the crankshaft, and with the simplified form of so in the center crankshaft you can have the another web, so that the total force acting on the crank pin is going to supported by means of the two number of webs, so that the total load is going to divide, that is instead of f cos theta into theta plus phi, you may get the f by 2 cos theta plus phi. So similarly, f by 2 cos sine theta plus phi, so that the load can be equally distributed among the two number of journals and two number of webs in the center type of crankshaft that we will discuss in next.